The documentary and the book that preceded it that I wrote with my family, my wife's a journalist too, Cornelia, starts really with a challenge of sorts that Owen issued. Owen is our son. He's now a 26-year-old autistic spectrum young adult. And around the time he was 19, he started to grow an awareness such that he was seeing more and more what the world saw of him. And one particular day, he says to Cornelia, he says, "Mom, people see you for who you are. And Dad, they see you for who you are. But they don't see me for who I am. I am more than I appear. I am a diamond in the rough, an unpolished gem." Now, anyone who's watched movies knows that's from Aladdin. And that's a typical Owen offering, a trenchant insight born of the way he sees the world that's maybe a little different than us, and then iced with a few lines from Disney. Now, the point is that Owen wasn't going to change. We knew that. We can't change him. So in some ways, what he was saying is maybe you could get the world to change, because I'm not going to change. That was the beginning of this process. The book then led to the documentary film, which was nominated for an Academy Award this year. And through it, people get to meet an autistic spectrum young adult, in some ways for the first time. Many people have never really spent time, a full 90 minutes, with someone on the spectrum, intimately, through their life. And by virtue of that, you see how people's perspectives can change. You also see what they're believing walking into the theater, though. Some of that's hard, and some of it's what we have seen for years, or did see, in terms of how the world saw Owen. We created a new kind of supportive, augmentative, joyful technology. It's called Sidekicks. You go to the App Store. It's on the App Store under Sidekicks. Originally, we built it for autistic spectrum folks, kids and young adults both. Now it's being embraced by lots of people. Very simply, it's a kind of a pairing device. I pair up with another phone. You have an avatar on your phone. When I type or talk into my phone, it comes through in the voice of the character on your phone. When you talk to the character, I can hear you wherever you are. Both characters are imaged on both phones, so it's kind of a conversation happening. And you can also stream video in real time, phone to phone. So I search on YouTube, video comes up, instantly it comes up on your phone in real time. We can watch, stop and start and discuss it through the avatars, which is fun. Then I search for something and it's you do when it's on my phone, I do it on your phone. It's a way to share the content of the world, not do it by yourself, but with your buddies. We call it campfiring. Spectrum folks, of course, this is crucial for them because they draw more from the content of the world than we tend to. They have to, that's the way they roll. So this allows them to share what they know to find. I know the best video. Here's what I see in it with you or their friends, and campfire around what gives them sustenance. But it's fun. It's great to share, and it's great as a place in which communities can gather around the campfire of the content we embrace and love.